Buongiorno everyone and welcome back. Today we will talk about solar panels, how do they work and how to calculate the wattage necessary to run your appliances and devices. But most important, do you really need one? And if so, which one? We will also talk in details about the foldable portable Dokio 100W solar panel. All the parts of this video are split in sections, so if you want to jump to the next one or get back to the previous one, just check in the description the timings or the navigation bar below. For those who don't know me, my name is Aldo. I'm an overlander, adventure traveler, nature and animal lover. I consider myself a citizen of the world, but I'm originally from Italy, so please
excuse any grammatical mistakes and my accent.
Together with my wife Vera and Toto, this Toyota Land Cruiser behind here that we converted into a tiny home on wheels, we have been driving around the world non-stop since 2016. And we drove on 5 continents and visited more than 50 countries. If you want to find out a little bit more about us, there is a quick 4-minute video just here. Solar panels generate DC, direct current, converting sunlight into power. This power goes through a charge controller that is then redirected to your batteries. There are mainly two types of solar panel, thin film and crystalline, both known as photovoltaic. Thin film are the cheaper options. They are made spraying a semiconductor material into a surface which is similar to the silvering back of the mirror. Their life expectancy is about 10 years, so half of the crystalline solar panels. Crystalline panels come in two options, monocrystalline and polycrystalline, with the first option being the most expensive but also the best durable and most efficient. The same wattage, a monocrystalline solar panel, it's smaller. Now, if you are looking to get a solar panel for your RV, it doesn't really matter this difference, but if you're doing a research for your house, it's important to separate the two kinds of crystalline solar panels. Now, how to calculate the wattage you need. A 100W solar panel will not be able to generate enough ampere to power the demand of maximum ampere needed by a 100W appliance, for example, a big compressor fridge. In simple words and generally speaking, you got to divide the wattage by the volt. A solar panel produces power at 18 volts, so a 100W solar panel at its best can generate about 5.5 ampere. On the other hand, a 12-volt appliance like a fridge, it will be needing at its peak about 8.3 ampere. Obviously, there are variables because a solar panel produces power during daylight, also depending on the weather and the sun position. And the fridge, it doesn't work at its peak all the time, but roughly just about a third each hour, so 20 minutes each hour. So before you buy a solar panel, it's important spending a decent amount of time doing some research. Otherwise, you will be put off by solar energy, because you will have either purchased something that doesn't provide you enough ampere, or you would have spent too much and you won't really get value for money. You need first to understand what you really need. And a good rule of thumb is to go out there camping. So get your vehicle, RV, camper out for the weekend. Stay off the grid and see how long your battery lasts. Don't overuse your appliances and keep an eye on the voltmeter. So if you have a 120 ampere leisure battery and it lasted you for 2 days, your consumption is about 60 ampere per day. You need to buy a solar panel that can generate 60 ampere per day. With the rough estimate, you are not going to need anything more than 150-160 watts. But if you want to play safe, a 200-220 watt system will do the job. Now the most important question, do you really need the solar panel? Well, that's up to you and the use you do with your vehicle. Obviously, if you only go out there for a weekend or you're always hooked up to the electricity in campsites, there is no really need for you to buy one. But if you like wild camping and you want to stay off the grid for longer, well, then considering buying a solar panel because it could be a good idea. This is our first solar panel. Despite having traveled for around 5 years, we didn't feel the need to have one so far. If you already watched our video with the full tour of Toto, you may remember that. If you haven't watched that video, you'll find it here. But now our circumstances have changed. We are heading to Africa, so we wanted to feel to be a little bit more self-sufficient and wanted to have an emergency device in case we need to recharge our batteries and we are somewhere in the wild. Also, if we like a place and we want to stay longer than the previous 3 days autonomy, we can now run our fridge properly and charge our devices. So this is the solar panel that we got. This is the Dokio 100W. It's a monocrystalline, foldable, portable solar panel. We have been trying it already for a week, and today we came to this beautiful secluded area in Sardinia to make a proper review of it. Apparently, at the moment, this is the best budget portable solar panel on the market. We bought it online at the price of about $125 or about 100 euros, 85 British pound. And it came very well packaged, and the box contained a charge controller, a 3-meter SA cable, and also with the little clamps, crocodile clamps for the batteries, and a short cable for a laptop. When it's folded, it's about 20 inches by 30, so when it opens, this becomes 40 by 30. In centimeters, it's about 50 centimeters by 70, and then it's 1 meter by 70. And obviously, the thickness is about a centimeter, so very little, like a third of an inch. It's very light, it only weighs about 2.7 kilograms, a little bit short of 6 pounds, and it's made of this very beautiful fabric. In front of here it's got like a nice pouch where you can keep all the accessories, and there is also some Velcro here that closes it and becomes its own little case. So it opens like this. Here we are. So for our use, it's best to put it on top of the roof rack, and that's where now we're going to go and position it. The good thing about a foldable solar panel is that you can angle it wherever the sun is facing it, because the more direct is the light, the sunlight, the more ampere you're going to get out of it. Let's go set it up and see how it works. Hey guys, you had appeared already. Beautiful, isn't it? So, that's the panel. Tap. So we got this cable connected to the panels, the cells. There is a little hole in here, we placed inside, so it goes back behind. I got a little bag, that's a hammock. I'm gonna use it here to make it more softer. The sun is facing that way because it's about 10 a.m. So I'm gonna incline it a bit like this. Perfect. We now connect the cable. That's the SA connector. Simple as that. The next steps are really important. It's how we connect the solar panel to the charge controller and the battery. So please watch carefully, because otherwise you could damage the charge controller. So that's the charge controller. We get the cable with the crocodile clips and connect it here where is the battery symbol, positive and negative. Then we connect it to the battery, positive, negative, and you will see that it's starting to show the charge, the voltage of the battery. It's now 12.8 volts. Then we connect the cable that is coming from the solar panel in here where is the solar panel symbol. 13 volts already, and it's producing 4.4 or 4.5 amperes. It's now 11 a.m. Obviously, when you want to disconnect everything, you need to do the same thing, but the opposite way. So you disconnect the solar panel first, then the two crocodile clips from the battery, positive and negative. That's the correct procedure, the correct way to connect the solar panel to the battery of a vehicle and the remote and the charge controller. We are also environmentalists and have recently started our very own charity organization called Try to Give Back. And we are using the revenue generated by our YouTube videos to fund our charitable actions. So please, if you haven't done that yet, smash the like button, subscribe to our channel and share our videos with your friends on Facebook, Instagram, WhatsApp. It doesn't really cost you a thing, but it means a lot for us. Thank you very much for your support. And if you would like to find out more, a little bit about our charity, there is a quick 2 minutes video here. While the solar panel is getting tanned, I'm going to tell you a little bit more about its specifications. It's sold as a 100 watts, but has got in fact 2x55 watts monocrystalline panels that are coated in insulated resin. The fabric is waterproof and mildew proof. And it's very easy to carry around, and it can be used from tent to camping up to RVs and boats, or also for emergency in case you want to have it in your car and you need a quick start with your batteries. In a couple of hours you'll charge them and you can start again. The maximum ampere output is rated at 6.1 ampere, but you have to consider the time of the day, the position of the sun, so the time of the year, the weather condition, and the actual inclination of the solar panel. Let's say that on the best day, at its peak, you're looking at something between 5 to 5.6 ampere. The other day it was sunny, so I recorded the solar panel performance from morning until sunset. I positioned the solar panel facing the sun in the best possible inclination, also moving the car accordingly. At 8 a.m. was already producing 2.2 ampere, but at 8:50, just 50 minutes later, it was already delivering 3.6 ampere, and that is already past the 50% mark of efficiency. 10 o'clock, 4.2, 11 a.m., 4.7, 11:55, so 5 minutes before noon, it was already delivering 5 ampere, and it stayed like that, it was the peak, until 3 p.m., reaching about 5.4, 5.6 ampere, around 1:30. After 3 and every subsequent hour, so 4, 5, 6, 7, it was losing 1 ampere per hour. 4, 3, 2, 1. I'm going to tell you now a very interesting fact. Solar panels do not work well if the day is too hot. And when it's cloudy, actually they're able to produce power, just less efficiently. However, if there are passing clouds, there is a spike in the output. A few days ago, it was giving rain, but I really needed to charge our batteries. They were very low, about 11.5 volts. The night before, I was finishing a nice video about us traveling through some of the most beautiful mountain regions in central Italy. And I was so much taken about the video, one drone image after the other, that I completely forgot to check the voltmeter. And when I did, it was too late. But I managed to finish the video, and you can watch it here. Let us know what you think. Despite the bad weather, I had to set up the solar panel. And in a matter of 2 hours, I already had the batteries charged enough that I could start the car. I was noticing that where a cloud was passing by, the surface of the panels were cooling down. But when the sun would come out again, there would be like a lensing effect, and the output would spike up to 6.6, 6.7, and even 7.1 ampere. And furthermore, this amperage stayed for quite a few minutes, so it maintained that sort of power. For the solar panel to work efficiently, it's important for the cells to be clean. For any dust forming, I use a little duster, but it's also important not to clean the surface of the panel too often. Don't do it when it's hot, and don't use strong chemicals. I use a camera lens cleaning solution with some wipes only when necessary. The charge controller comes with the instruction manual. It's a little bit basic, so you will need to read it through a few times. And to make your life a bit easier, I'm gonna help you showing you the main functions of it. The charge controller is rated 10 ampere, and it has got 3 SAA ports in here. This is the in for the solar panel, and then you got 2 output. The battery, and that's the load. So this is like for a laptop, for example. So you got this short cable here that gets inside here in case you want to connect something like a laptop here. Also got 2 USB exit here, 5 volts, 2 ampere. That you can use it to charge anything that can use a USB, so like a mobile phone, power bank, camera batteries, and so on. This is the main display. As you can see, the solar panel is showing with an arrow the battery, so it's charging the battery. It's now 3 p.m., so the solar has been up for quite a few hours, and all the system now is showing 13.6 volts. If we press this button on top of here, we change a different display. So starting from the first one, that's the amperage, 4.5, 4.6, of what the solar panel is giving to the battery, is now producing. Then we go here, and that's the output. In case we would have a load, connected to this one like a laptop, but now it shows 0 ampere because nothing is connected to it. If we continue, this shows you the setting you want to have for the solar panel to charge the battery. In our case, it's 13.7. Anything between 13.7 and 14.2 is good for the lead acid batteries. Here is showing the starting point when the controller will start to give charges to a load, and is set to 12.6 volts. So once the system reaches 12.6 volts, energy will be given to a laptop, for example. And the next display shows you when the battery, when the charger is gonna stop giving energy, electricity, power to the load, in case you don't have enough power. And that's now set on 10.7 volts. So this is the working mode, and it's set on 24 hours, which is the continuous. In case someone would want to change the hours and have it work during the day and not in the night, the changes can be done there. Then the next one is the setting of the battery. You got B01, B02 and B03. The first one, in my case, is for the lead acid battery. But then B02 and B03 are for setting the batteries with the lithium ion or lithium phosphate battery. This one and this, they have to do with the dusk till dawn setting. So in case you want to change the continuous working load with just some hours of the day. So I advise just to leave it like that. And then finally, we've got the last one. This one is the short circuit function, and this way it's on. So I advise to leave it on, because in case there is a short circuit, this will prevent any damages. In case you want to change some settings, for example, the amount of volts that you want the solar panel to deliver to the battery, you just basically go to that display, which is this one, you keep it pressed, and it will start to blink. With these two arrows, so the pointed up is plus, the pointed down is minus, you decide the power, for example, that you want to the solar panel to deliver to the battery. Let's say, for example, 14 volts. You press it again, and now the solar panel is bringing a charge of 14 volts to the battery. So in conclusion, I would suggest leaving all the settings the way it comes from the factory, because this is a kind of solar panel that you only use during the day, so there is no point of messing with the continuous working mode and so on. When it's daylight, you take it out. When it's night, you fold it, you put it back. What you will use, which is something that you will check, is just the first function that will tell you what kind of amperage that the solar panel is producing. And I would say this one, in case you want to change the output voltage of the solar panel to the battery, but I wouldn't go any higher than 13.8, at least for the lead acid battery. It may seem complicated, but in fact it's very intuitive, so with a bit of practice you should have no problem. But it's very important, as soon as you open it up, before connecting it, that you check that the setting for the right battery type is already pre-imposted in there, otherwise it could damage your batteries. The downsides of the Dokio 100 watts are not many. We are actually very happy about it, and we know that if treated with care, this solar panel will last us a long time. Being lightweight and flexible also means that in the long run, with the sun's heat, it may deform a bit, especially if you place it standing, laying on the side of a vehicle. Also, I've noticed that there are no eyelets for grommets, so in case I would want to put a rope inside to secure it better for windy days, I cannot do so. However, there are some handles on the side, they are quite tough fabric, so that can be used for this purpose. I hope you liked the video and it did provide you with some useful information. Again, there is a link in the description that will take you to our Amazon page, where you can find not just the solar panel, but all our gear. If you click and make a purchase, it will not change the price you pay, but we will get a small commission that can help us raising funds for our charity organization. Thank you for your support. If you have any questions, please let us know in the comments below. Don't forget to watch our other videos and subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching. Arrivederci.
I'm Vera. And this is Aldo.
Yay!
And this is our tiny home on wheels, Toto. We have been driving around the world for the past 4 years, visiting over 50 countries on 5 continents. Witnessing with our own eyes how beautiful, but at the same time how fragile our world is. Click on the subscribe button and join our adventure.